68, and the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships. By the way, therefore, I spake unto thee, thou shalt see it no more again. You see that? The Lord said he was going to bring you into Egypt again with ships. Now let's examine that real quick before we go a little further. Because I know y'all thinking one thing. Y'all hear Egypt, y'all think Africa. Egypt, that's another name for that land in Africa. But that real name is named after the person that he's the progenitor of that land. His name was Mizraim. That was Noah's grandson. That was Noah's grandson. He come from Ham. Ham was one of Noah's sons. Ham had a son named Mizraim. He's the father of the Egyptians today. Egypt don't mean that land. That land was named after the man that progenitorized that land. The word Egypt is a Greek word. It means bondage, lockup, which is what you Negroes was in when you came over here. You Negroes weren't no Muslims. Hell, the Muslims sold you. Islam? The damn Arabs, Ishmael, he's the father of the Arabs. They sold you. They got together with these damn stinky Africans, and they sold you. The Africans are not our people. You guys are not African. The word Africa comes from a white man named Leo Scipios Africanus. He put his name on that land when he conquered those people. They don't even know who the hell they are. They call Ham. And the African's name is Ham in the Bible. You not no Africans, you Negroes. You Negroes are the Jews in the Bible. And you got to get used to calling yourself that. Because guess what? When Christ come back, ain't going to be no party. It ain't going to be no party. I know the Catholic Church says it's going to be a big almighty cry. We all going to be together in the streets. We all going to be different nations, hugging and kissing. We all going to know. That's not the Bible. That's your emotions. The Bible say that God, when Christ come back, he's going to separate everybody. Everybody going back to their own people. Game over. Game over. I know some of you Negroes hate that, but too damn bad. I hate seeing y'all dying. Hell, I hate losing my people. That's what we talking about. We talking about life and death right now. We ain't talking about your damn emotions. And we ain't no damn Martin Luther King civil rights movement up here. We shall all be done. I mean, we shall all overcome. That ain't gonna happen. You Negroes are worse off now than you were 50 years ago. You guys ever heard of Black Wall Street? 1923? Those Negroes had 35 city blocks in Tulsa, Oklahoma. Tulsa, Oklahoma. You Negroes ain't got a block right now. You Negroes don't own no more. All the ancestors that own houses in Oakland, as soon as they die, the kids on crack, they sell the shit. I mean, they sell the houses, excuse my French. I'm just a little pissed off about things that's going on with our people. But they sell the houses, and they split it up, go get on more crack, and there's no more house. Big Mama dead. The father's dead. The house that was once owned by the black family is now sold to another nation and nobody have a house. Now you down in Oakland, you're trying to get on GA and get welfare and get low income housing.
That's right, Art.
Something is wrong here, folks. Something is wrong. We had a young man just bit a baby nose off on Sunday. You guys see that?
That's right.
Young man bit the baby nose off, a brother with dreadlocks. They showed him on the news. He bit the baby nose off and beat the baby in the head, a 1-month-old baby. I think either 1 or 3 months old. He was a newborn.
That's right.
Bit the baby nose off. Right. What is the hell going on with you kids, man? Talk to me. We don't talk to your parents. Talk to us, man. What's wrong? I'm sorry, okay, we're gonna finish it up. So right now we've told you that the Lord said he was gonna send his people into Egypt by ships. Egypt means bondage, a ship is a ship. You call them cruise ships today, we call them hell back then. Because we was on the bottom of them. Packed in like sardines. So we're going into Egypt by ships. That's in the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 68. You can go and read it for yourself. Oh, we got flyers right here that will refer you to that. So right now we're going to Egypt by ships, and then what?
And there ye shall be sold unto your enemies for bond men and bond women, and no man shall buy you.
You hear that, folks? That's coming out the Holy Bible. The same book y'all claim to cling to, and you know it, and you saved by the blood. But guess what? In this Bible, it tells you that you Negroes are going to come into slavery by ships. You're going to be in bondage, and you're going to be sold on auction blocks. That's what happened to you Negroes. Tell me it didn't happen. Anybody walk up here and tell me it didn't happen. We know history. You Negroes don't read. So like I said, y'all just listen. Right. We the teachers. We're running this. If you got a question, you got discourse and rebuttal, we open for that, but you're not running nothing.
That's
you
right.
Failed. A lot of you elders failed. You failed.
That's right.
You failed. Christ didn't come and die for everybody. I don't care what you sing or what you think. The Bible breaks down John 3:16. And then it tells you we were going to be sold on auction slave blocks as bond men and bond women, as slave men and slave women. And then it said nobody going to buy you. Now that's key, because the word buy is a Hebrew word. It means redeem, save. God said nobody going to save you this time. I sent Moses. I sent a lot of other prophets to warn you. But this time, God said you got to come back to me in the name of my son. And guess what? You Negroes got a lot of different religions. Ain't none of them worked. Islam ain't gonna save you. There's no salvation in Islam. Christianity, there's no salvation in Christianity. Buddhas, there's no salvation in Buddha. These are all idols. You got this in slavery. You Negroes and the Jews of the Bible, and you Latinos is with us. Y'all the children of Israel. Y'all gotta come back to the Father as the truth, the children of Israel.
That's right.
I know y'all don't like that. I know y'all wanted me to come up here and pass out cupcakes and sing Kumbaya. Kumbaya wasn't no good song, by the way. Y'all say Kumbaya, but Kumbaya, they was calling on their God. Those slaves was in hell. They was picking cotton in the hot ass heat in Mississippi and in the South, and they wanted out. And they was singing Kumbaya, come by here, Lord. Get me out of here. And you niggas say Kumbaya like it's something good. Y'all ain't know what Kumbaya mean. That was broken English for come by here, y'all. Yahweh.
That's right.
That's what they were saying. Anybody got something to say about it, come up here and we can get it. Because I want you to get edified. I want you people to know this. God wants y'all to know. And whoever you want to get this, you're going to get it. We're not begging nobody.
Right.
We're not pressing nobody. Right. You're going to get this. If it ain't for you, God ain't going to deal with you. Sit here and be with the white men.
Right.
Worship these idols and die with the white men and the other nations. Because
right.
They all idol worship. Put down your crosses. Put down your Buddha statues. Put down Elvis Presley as Jesus. Come back to God in peace. In truth, excuse me. And learn where you are according to the Bible. We can sing all we want to, it ain't gonna help you. Those little children in Montgomery, Alabama, they was listening to songs
all
that
praise,
morning
all
before
praise.
They died in that bomb. I'm sorry.
She said because she happy to see you.
Huh?
She said because she happy to see us.
Bless your heart. Well, thank you. I thought you were trying to shoot me off. Thank you. Bless your heart, sister. Sing the truth now. Sing the truth. It's time to wake up, folks. We in those last days. We in those last days. If you're gonna sing, sing the truth. Sing the truth. Singing is good. That's the talent that our people got. Singing, dancing.
She a Benjamite, huh?
You know, I can see that. I can see, I'm looking at her. She's
yeah.
Like she a Benjamite.
Yeah.
Hey, sister, you from the tribe of Benjamin.
That's right.
Paul was one of you. If Apostle Paul was on earth right now, he was right there with you.
That's
he
right.
Was a Benjamite, sis.
That's right.
Paul was a Benjamite.
That's
bless
right.
Your heart. We got flyers up here. Y'all want to take a flyer home and read for yourself? Read. Reading is fun to mental. It's fun for your mental. Computers damage your mental if you do too much of it. Reading is fun to mental. And they say, what's the old cliche? If you want to hide it from a Negro, or in this case, a Latino, put it in the book.
That's right.
You know why that's true? Because the white man said, he said that Elvis Presley was God, but then in the Bible it says that he was dark skinned.
That's right.
So that just shows you that you don't read. Reading is fundamental. All you brothers that claim to be pastors and bishops, you Negroes better start preaching the truth, or y'all gonna die. Y'all already dying. You already got chaos in your church. Brothers is falling out of churches by the boatloads. Brothers don't know that. Brothers need substance. We don't go for all that preaching. That stuff don't do nothing for us. Negroes looking for a way out. You women, y'all like all that stuff. All them lies and all that preaching and rolling, holy rolling. We don't like that. Negroes looking for a way out, man. We need substance. And you brothers, you pastors, y'all fail. That's y'all right. Failing us.
That's right.
We out here dying. You Negroes ain't even telling these brothers why they dying.
That's right.
It's in the Bible.
Second Chronicles, chapter 7, verse 14. If my people, who are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and heal their land.
You hear that? All the Heavenly Father is looking for us to do is repent. Repent, keep these laws in His Bible, so we can get out of here, man.
That's right.
What's hard about that, man?
Ain't nothing hard.
I'm trying to get out of here, man. I'm tired of working for this white man.
Huh.
I got a good job. Some of you say good. I'm tired of that damn job, though. Because ain't nothing good than the kingdom that we finna inherit.
Huh.
The Negroes and Latinos finna inherit the kingdom of heaven. And these Gentile heathen nations, you're going to be there too. But you're going to be serving. You're going to be serving in the kingdom of heaven. You're going to be right there with us. You're going to cleave to the nation of Israel. Matter of fact, God, give me that Isaiah 14. Okay, we got Bibles up here. We got literature. Don't be afraid. Grab one and go about your business.
That's right.
If you need to call us, call us. We here for you. But we got to stop this madness, man. This brother just brought a scripture out in 2 Chronicles. 2 Chronicles 7, verse 14. The Heavenly Father said we just humble ourselves. Gotta humble ourselves, folks. Gotta humble ourselves. You gotta humble yourself to the white man when you go to court.
That's right.
When you Negroes go to court, y'all get shot. Y'all go to court, y'all get a suit, slacks. I'm talking about thugs who sag. Y'all go to court, y'all put on the belt, y'all put on the tie, y'all put on a suit, and y'all walk up and y'all be looking so innocent. That's for the white man. Do that for the Father.
That's right.
Give him that same honor.
That's right.
And watch our communities change. Watch you stop hearing about little kids dying. But you guys ain't doing that right now. So therefore, we got to see the news every night. We got to watch the Channel 10 news, the Channel 2 at 10 o'clock news every night. Every night. Somebody's dying in Richmond, Oakland, or Frisco, or Sacramento, or L.A. Or if you watch the world news, Chicago, New York, New Jersey, Philadelphia, Killadelphia, they call it. New Orleans. You Negroes gotta wake up.
Huh.
You Latinos too. You Latinos right here with us. I'm sorry, I know y'all to know that. Y'all the children of Israel too. Y'all gotta wake up, man. Y'all gotta wake up.
This is the word of the Lord of hosts. I took you from the pastures and from following the sheep to be prince over my people Israel. I have been with you wherever you have gone and have destroyed all the enemies in your path. I will make you a great name among the great ones of the earth. I will assign a place for my people in Israel. There I will plant them, and they shall dwell in their own land.